4.
Tennis Channel Live from the Open, presented by Mercedes-Benz, begins at 8 a.m. Eastern, 5 a.m. Pacific, live every day from New York City. We'll bring you 3 hours of pre-match coverage, analysis, interviews, assorted nonsense every single morning. You are looking at the Grandstand. And this is, it's the last year of play at the Grandstand. Marty Fish, playing in his final U.S. Open, put this out. I requested Grandstand court. Intimate, awesome crowds. Guess what, Marty? Your wish is the USGA's command. He has put, his match has been put on the Grandstand court. With me, Ed McGrogan, who's the senior editor of Tennis Magazine. This is the latest magazine out, and you have done a salute to the Grandstand.
I did. It's
and you're way too young to be that fond and that reminiscing.
Many of the great matches were before I was around. That's true. There have been some great ones over the time. Marty, you know, he gets that match there. And
it's a tough match, too.
It is a tough match under his circumstances, but I always said that this is the most American court at the U.S. Open because I think the stories come out best there. You inevitably get, you know, the fans and the crowd bring it to life. And think Marty's tweet there to request it over Ash Armstrong just puts a pen on that there.
He plays Stokowski today. All right, first of all, you have to explain to me, because I happen to love the Grandstand too, what makes a great Grandstand match? Is it the matchup? Is it the fact that it's an American or a Brazilian playing in front of thousands of Brazilian fans?
I mean, you get the crowds. The crowds is the obvious thing. Everybody says it's an intimate court, and that's the cliche with it, but it's true. You know, I think early in the tournament, you get, you know, the big names are on Ash, and you get sort of just under that tier, perhaps, on Grandstand. And what happens, I think the best matches tend to filter to that third largest court. And I think you get some of the best week one matches. And I think it's where you want to be if you have the grounds pass. Always have been.
I love it when at Louis Armstrong Stadium, you see the people craning over the lip of the, you know, the top of the stadium to watch what's going on. We've picked out a couple of great Grandstand matches. Again, you were probably getting burped at the time most of these were happening.
Perhaps.
But Vitas Gerulaitis beating Ivan Lendl. I was in the Grandstand for that match. It was sensational. Chris Evert lost to Lori McNeil there. That was a big one. Brad Gilbert beat Boris Becker there. I mean, and again, it's what happens when all of a sudden people are here and there's an upset.
And Brad doesn't let that match go. He's going to remind you about that as it goes on and on. So that's, you know, that's perhaps the one of those pre-myself times that I remember most.
Because I'm just, he
won't let you forget it.
Yes.
Exactly. I mean, one of the favorites I went to in person was 5 years ago, Harrison and Stokowski. I think that was one of the more, you know, just electric matches, really, of the entire tournament. It was one that Harrison didn't, you know, he didn't fare well in the end after 3 match points. But it's one that I think just typifies the whole experience of being at the Open, seeing it that close, and just kind of, you know, being there with the player.
He
even told me, I mean, it's just as much due to the fans as it is to his game, in a sense. And
it's immersive. You feel as a fan that you can help the outcome of the match, right? Here's a look at some of the Grandstand matches out there today. Again, Marty Fish requested it, and he got it. Karolina Pliskova is going to be out there. David Ferrer, boy, that poor guy needs some wins, doesn't he? And then Madison Keys and Clara Kukalova. This is going to be great. Now, here's my question to you.
Go ahead.
Earlier in the show, we had Gordon Smith, the executive director, Grand Poobah of the OCA, explaining to us that if I liked the old Grandstand, I would love the new Grandstand, and it looks beautiful. It's going to hold 8,000 fans. Will it still have that Grandstand vibe?
I would say there's no way you could replicate it because I think that what's going to happen is it will resemble more the Court 17 feel, which is a great court in its own, but what I hit on in the piece about Grandstand is that not only is it intimate, it also really has allowed different viewing perspectives that you don't get anywhere else. You just talked about Armstrong, people craning over to watch the matches there. You get that vibe. You know, Pete Bodo got hit by a roast beef sandwich one time by someone who...
Friend of the show, Peter Bodo.
Of course. And, you know, under the shade, there's almost no relief from that during the Open. You could sit behind the baseline. There's all different, you know, perspectives of that court, which to me, I think is going to be very tough to replicate down the road. I hope they do a great job with it because, you know, it should live up to its predecessor, which is my favorite court of all.
And the great thing, it's the last year of the Grandstand, the current Grandstand, and there is no signage that says roast beef hitting section, no road. I mean, so you just got to guess. Anyway, Ed, we love the article.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Friend of the show, Ed McGrogan. Much more to come on our 3 hours of coverage of the U.S. Open. Tennis Channel Live continues after this.